How do you stop comparing yourself to your ex's rebound? Going through a breakup can be really tough, and when your ex is in a new rebound relationship, it can just really mess with your mind. That's what we're gonna be getting into this video here. Hey there, it's Clay with modernlove.life. And again, today we are talking about how to stop comparing yourself to your ex's rebound. And this is something that I might have a little bit of personal experience with. If you have been following the series on my personal story through breakups and everything like that with my big ex, I'll put a link to it up there, a video playlist up there with my story and all that. But you know that pretty much every time my ex and I broke up, she got into a rebound relationship or got attached to someone else. And that, of course, caused me to start thinking like, hey, who is this other guy? Is he better than me? What's wrong with me? All these lovely sort of thoughts, right? I wanted to talk to you a little bit here from personal experience and maybe some things that I wish I had done differently back then, if I could go back and talk to my younger self about these sorts of things back then. But the first thing is that you want to realize that when you are comparing yourself to your ex's rebound, you are investing your energy into lack, into insecurity, into scarcity. You're basically saying like, okay, there's this other person over here and then there's me here. What is wrong with me and what's so great about this other person? And of course, when you ask yourself questions like that, you will find answers, even if you have to make them up. Like I could say, oh, well, this other person is better than me because I'm half Japanese and half white. Therefore, you know, who wants to be in a relationship with someone like that? That's kind of weird. Like, that's a belief I used to have. Oh, because I have a small family. My parents are divorced. I'm not in great terms with my dad. Okay, that's a belief I used to have as well, too. Or, oh, hey, you know, I'm still in school, or I'm still trying to figure out my career, or I'm still this, or I'm still that, or I'm not tall enough, or I'm not in shape, or whatever it might be, right? There are all these things that you can find wrong with you if you were to really start asking yourself questions that would cause you to look at them. Or there's things that you can find perfectly impeccable about this other person that you could probably discover if you were to ask the right question as well too, even if you have to make these things up. So I'm asking you to not invest your energy into all of that and to instead ask yourself like, okay, like what is it I actually want to invest my energy into? Rather than finding everything wrong with me, what is it I want to invest my energy into? Is it, okay, I actually want to, you know, move towards having a great loving relationship. Okay, do that. But you're not gonna do that by trying to find everything that's wrong with you or trying to find everything that's perfect about this other person. But bring your energy into alignment, bring your emotions into alignment with the relationship you want to experience and go ahead and live into that, as we've talked about in many other videos here, rather than finding everything that is potentially wrong with you here. The next thing I want to bring up here is the idea of focusing in solely on this rebound. Now, again, I know that this feels like the right thing to do, especially if you want to get back together with your ex. You know, you want to say, okay, like, how are they progressing? Are they really serious? Are they not serious? What are my chances here? Are they like pulling away from me and getting closer to the other person and blah, 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 all of this sort of stuff. Of course, there's the whole comparison angle of this as well, too. Like we just talked about, what's so great about them? What's wrong with me? Just as you don't want to be micro-analyzing everything that your ex says and does, you also don't want to be putting every piece of attention that you have onto this other person or onto this rebound relationship as well too. Because number one, that's just going to rile you up. It's just going to agitate you like, oh my goodness, did you hear that they did this? Or oh my goodness, did you hear that they're now moving in together or something like that? And if you have like some friends that are giving you these sorts of updates, just politely tell them like, hey, keep me out of the loop on that for now. I need to work on me. I need to work on making sure that I'm focused and centered on myself, focused on my own personal healing, focused on what I want for myself. And if you are giving me these updates about like, oh my goodness, did you see the thing on Facebook? Like, that's not going to help me. Have that conversation with them if you need to. But also know that you peeking on them, you checking out their social media, et cetera, isn't going to help you either. So just be mindful of that. Again, this is all from personal experience. It really is. Okay, the third thing I want you to take from this is that you can learn something from this. You know, you can learn something from your whole breakup experience. And it shouldn't be something like, oh yeah, I suck, or oh yeah, I'm not as good as this other person. Again, we don't want to create that comparison thing here, but we want to say, okay, what is it I can learn from this whole experience that's going to allow me to move powerfully forward into whatever might be next, you know, the next relationship or getting back together or learning something about life or learning something about myself or learning something about love? What is actually going to empower you here? So just take an honest stock, an honest look at your relationship. What didn't work? Don't take on all the responsibility yourself. I know that we often take on all the responsibility ourselves and say like, oh yeah, it's because I wasn't this or I wasn't that and they're this perfect person. But like, you know, take an honest look at it and be like, okay, sure. Maybe I was too wrapped up in this or maybe I wasn't paying enough attention to that. But you know what? They didn't communicate things as well either. So maybe that's something to take from it. Okay, have more communication. Prioritize connection, whatever it might be, but learn things from this that you can move forward with that are going to allow you to become more aligned with the kind of relationship that you want and the kind of person that you really want to be through this whole experience. The next thing I want to encourage you to do is to really forgive yourself. Again, I know that there are a lot of people that take on blame and responsibility for the breakup. Oh, if I wasn't so emotional. Oh, if I didn't say this, if I didn't lash out, if I didn't, work so hard, if I wasn't so caught up in this or that, then things would be different. And I don't know, maybe they would be. But you know what? It's not like you were intentionally going out of your way to sabotage the relationship. It's not like you were intentionally trying to screw this up. You were doing the best that you could with the information that you had and with the understanding that you had about love and yourself and relationships and men or women or whatever. You were doing the best that you could with what you had at the time. And so what I want you to do is I want you to just lovingly forgive yourself and say, okay, like if I was to talk to my younger self, I'd say, okay, hey, you know, maybe you were a little bit too focused on your career and all of that stuff. And maybe you thought the relationship was just like rock solid and you took it for granted a little bit. And maybe that wasn't the case, but you know what? Like, you don't need to beat yourself up over this. You can let it go. You were doing the best that you could. And in your own way, you were trying. And maybe it wasn't landing with her just the right way, but you were trying. And what you could learn from this is like, okay, maybe we need to, you know, touch base a little bit more. Maybe we need to have more open, honest, vulnerable conversations with one another. Maybe I need to actually practice a little bit more openness and honesty and vulnerability myself too. Positive vulnerability, like we've talked about in a previous video here. And when you can start to do this, you're going to set yourself up for really learning things as we move forward through all of this. And then the last thing that I think is really super important when it comes to all of this is to make an intentional, not a reactionary sort of decision, but an intentional decision about what is it you want to create and step forward into from here. So easy to get caught in reactionary stuff as the result of breakups, especially if there's rebound relationships involved, but it's really easy to get caught up in reaction. But instead, what I want you to do is I want you to say, okay, I'm going to calm myself down. I'm going to get out of damage control mode. I'm going to focus in on my values, what's important to me energetically, where I want to go with life, all that sort of stuff. And I'm going to say, okay, this is what I want to do. This is what's important to me. This isn't just like, okay, well, they got with someone else. I'm going to get with someone else too. Or, well, they said this. I need to prove them wrong and get back together with them or whatever. But it's like, okay, what is it I actually want to step into in my life? What is it I'm intentionally stepping into in my life? If you can do this intentionally, not out of reaction, you're really setting yourself up for a lot of positivity through all of this. And you're really setting yourself up to thrive and succeed with all of this. You know, this is what we really talk about and really emphasize in our course called Emotional Freedom. It helps set you up to heal from a breakup, whether you're wanting to do that for the purposes of getting back together with your ex or whether you're wanting to do that for the purposes of, you know, moving forward and creating a new relationship with someone else. You know, Emotional Freedom is a great place to start because it helps get you right emotionally so that you can kind of step forward into whatever that next step might be. Again, you can check it out over at modernlove.life/EF for emotional freedom. E is in emotional, F is in freedom. But yeah, that's a great place to start. And if there's something else you'd like to check out in terms of healing emotionally, I'd also recommend you check out this video playlist over here on getting over a breakup. Anyway, with that being said, thanks so much. Take care, and I'll talk to you in the next video.